The human appropriation of natural resources is a major concern of our society. We will review the enormous stock of energy resources that is stored in our planet and the rate at which they are replenished. The Earth receives a continuous flow of energy as solar radiation. The Sun is indeed the prime mover of many other energy forms. It is possible to tag some of these forms under the name of renewable energy, to link the direct and indirect connection with solar radiation. Energy from wind, ocean waves, currents and thermal gradients, waterfalls or running water and biomass are all forms of solar energy harvested from the great planetary cycles. Let's understand, for instance, why should we classify wind energy as a form of solar energy. The Sun heats unevenly the atmosphere, causing gradients of temperature, density and pressure in the air. High and low pressure regions are therefore originated, which are also affected by the Earth's rotation and the irregularities of the Earth's surface. When different masses of air get in contact, air flows from higher to lower pressure regions as a deflating balloon. The assessment of the theoretical availability of different renewable energy flows is a difficult task. The starting point is to consider how solar radiation drives the major processes of the hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. After accounting for the Earth albedo, only approximately 70% of the incoming solar radiation reaches the Earth's surface. This is equivalent to around 3,800,000 exajoules per year of solar energy flow. This value is further reduced by the atmospheric absorption. Waterfalls and running waters account for around 200 exajoules per year, a very small fraction of the energy driving the planetary water cycle. The theoretical potential for wind and wave energy flows are respectively around 110,000 exajoules and 31,000 exajoules per year. Photosynthetic processes drive biomass production at a rate of around 2,000 exajoules per year. The contribution from geothermal heat and tidal energy generated by gravity fields is instead much lower. Finally, energy extraction from ocean thermal gradients show a high potential, but still there are not available solutions for the harvest. These energy flows far exceed annual global needs of humankind. However, they need to be reduced to a so-called technical potential of energy production that considers many other sensitive factors. Among the others, the most important are the energy needed to sustain some critical ecological processes, the screening of accessible areas for energy harvesting, and the current technical availability of conversion technologies. The elaboration of data from the International Institute for Applied Systems Analysis clearly shows how technical potential greatly reduces with respect to the theoretical availability. Notably, solar energy far exceeds the magnitude of other renewable energy forms. Similarly, energy stocks of our planet other than nuclear resources are originated in billion years from solar energy flow. They have been defined as buried sunshine to recall their linkage, often very ancient, with the energy from the Sun. Hence, which are the main energy stocks in our planet? The bulk of world phytomass is stored in forests. Especially tropical rainforests dominate the scene. According to Vaclav Smil, a leading scientist in the field of planetary energetics, the global phytomass store is in the range of 500 to 800 gigatons of carbon. If we assume an average value of 600 gigatons of carbon for total phytomass, this number translates in around 20 zettajoules of energy equivalent. The Sun is also responsible for the net yearly growth of vegetation. The net increment in the biosphere goes under the name of net primary productivity, NPP. Net primary productivity is defined as the net flux of carbon from the atmosphere into green plants and describes the amount of vegetable matter produced per year. NPP is a fundamental ecological variable as it measures the energy input to the biosphere. Net primary productivity is the net amount of primary production after the cost of plant respiration is included. Among the barred sanction stocks, biomass is the youngest resource with storage time in the order of few years or decades. NPP can be also recovered as stores of ancient solar energy in coal, oil, or gas. This is the ultimate fossil energy stock that is feeding the metabolism of our civilization.